This is the Bloody Crypt on hard. Since I ran this quest the last time, I ran Chronoscope and was able to get this Staff of Natgan, which isn't great, but it does have silver. So I'm going to use this against the end boss when we get there. Now, in this quest, it's mostly, in fact, almost all undead, so there's really no point in using my Vorpal Keen. I do get a little bit of extra base damage, but probably better off using this holy weapon, which will do at least a little of extra holy
Bats
damage
flutter
to the
over your
enemies.
head in this dark, cramped space. Crystals are set into the columns of this chamber. The room might also have a way to activate them.
All right, we'll go south first.
The Burning Path.
Thank you.
burning path. The Crimson Path. The Crimson Path. mortal path. The Sanguine Path. The Sanguine Path. The Sanguine Path.
All right, I'm going to switch to my silver weapon. not needed against these Gallo whites, or these whites in general, but for the end fight, I guess I could just do that right when we get to the end fight. Don't need to do that right away. I'm going to put on my spot goggles for my... And I guess I'll... don't think I need my true seeing on, but I'm going to go ahead and stick my true seeing on. Actually, wait, I don't need my... I've got this spot. That's pretty good. So, I don't think I need my true seeing on. My spot should be good enough, especially with this plus 10 spot that we got from the end fight. Or the end reward for Sorrow Dusk. Alright, so now it's pretty straightforward.
The Black Abbot's projection floats in midair.
All we have to do with our spot is walk by these. Things will keep respawning until we find it.
Stones at your feet are worn smooth. The stones at your feet are worn smooth.
So we get this message. One of these two coffins is the one that we need. There it is. Now we can fight the boss. We've got our silver weapon. So it gets around its damage reduction. It doesn't do the most damage, but... And we'll have a better weapon. We've already upgraded our items, so we don't need to use this altar. And because this part can be confusing, I'm just going to real quick get the end reward. And retake the quests for running on Reaper. Nothing too exciting here. Alright, so when I get this, I'm going to say repeat the heretical path quest. This will reset the entire quest chain, and you can see I get a bunch of messages. And now I can retake the level 5 quest for running on Reaper. And like before, we will not, when we complete these quests, we won't retake them. We will just wait till we finish the chain, as that breaks the flagging. Alright, so that is the Bloody Crypt on Hawk.